Welcome to our jewelry shop. Is there anything you're looking for in particular? Well, we have quite an array here for you. We have earrings, we have bracelets, we have necklaces of different lengths and colors, and we have some interesting pieces as well. Would you like me to go over any of them for you to help you decide what you like and or to see what kind of jewelry we offer here? Okay, well, sure. Is there anything you'd like to start with? Do you want to start with the earrings, the bracelets, the necklaces, or the interesting piece? Okay, well, when it comes to necklaces, we have quite a few of different lengths too. So I think what I'll do is I'll show you our longer necklaces first, and then we'll go on from there, okay? So for our first necklace, we have this beautiful Dreamcatcher. It has the typical Dreamcatcher look to it, although it almost looks like a lotus flower too. It has these dangling pieces here. We have a leaf, another leaf, and in the middle of the leaves, we have in the middle of the necklace, we have a little jewel. You can see right there. Little jewel. It is a fake jewel. It's not real. Holding these pendants together is this chain, silver chain right here. It's not ridiculously delicate, but it's still thin enough. Before these pendants show up, we have another piece that mimics the look of the Dreamcatcher down here. So it's almost like a mini Dreamcatcher. And this one also has a jewel in the center. Once again, it is a fake jewel. However, all the jewelry we sell are very quality. The jewel will not rot. This is the back of it. Just plain. So good. Now the chain is very long. It's very long. So you can wear this pretty much down to your belly button. However, the chain is adjustable. So you have these larger rings here. See how thin these are and small? These are larger loops that you can stick in. Closure. So you would take this little piece here, push it down. It opens the mouth of the claw, and you can open it and stick it on any of the rings. The closer to the chain piece that you go, the smaller the necklace will be. So you can adjust its length. It's very helpful to be able to adjust it, partially because everyone's a different size, but also because the clothing you wear can affect if you can see the necklace or not. Say, for instance, you have a very busy shirt, many patterns or something like that, and you want to show it on your actual neck, you would need the necklace higher up so that you can display it more readily. However, if you wanted to and you have a plain shirt like I do, you can easily stick it on the shirt itself and you can go as far down as you're comfortable with it. So that's the first piece. What do you think? Okay. I know, we have many pieces, so it's hard to decide when you only see one. But do you like the Dreamcatcher theme? Are you into Native American culture at all? Or do you just like the symbol itself? Okay. Well, we do have one more. One more Native American style piece. Theme. This one is a bit different. The Dreamcatcher itself, it has a similar pattern to the previous necklace. However, this one has 1, 2, 3 feathers of different lengths. So these are smaller feathers on the side, and in the middle we have similar to the other one. It looks, it's supposed to be a spider web, but it does look kind of like a lotus flower. And in the center, we have the same type of bead, same type of jewel that is fake. Now, the chain on this one is more looped, so it's a wider looped chain. Special about this one though is it's a double necklace, which means there is a second necklace that comes along with it that you can pair with it. The second necklace is smaller, has a shorter chain. This is a crystal in a tower-esque shape. It's actually quite pointy, but it has beautiful detailing. A tighter, smaller looped chain compared to the Dreamcatcher. So you'd have this smaller pendant, and then you'd have this longer piece with the Dreamcatcher at the bottom. So you have 2 for 1, and there are multiple chains. I'm not gonna lie, they do get stuck on each other quite a bit. You can't separate each necklace, they come as a pair. But just like the other one, we have our lobster closure. We can open it like this. Once again, we have these larger loops that you can stick it on. And you see where the smaller necklace the larger one, and the closer you get to the second necklace, the shorter it'll be. But you can go down this chain here to make it longer if you wish. Personally, I think it's long enough, but it's very versatile. You can switch it up however you wish. Okay. Any thoughts on this one? Yeah. And look at others. I actually have. Let me see. Alright. If you like the crystals from the other necklace, the previous necklace, you might enjoy this. It's a very, very simple necklace. There is a lot of beauty here. This is a rose quartz crystal. I know it's hard to see it. It's a very, very light pink. And it has this wiring around it. This is a handmade piece, so the crystal is real. It is a real quartz point. If you enjoy rose quartz, which is good for the heart chakra, which is an energy center, that it's all about love, and you want this over your heart, it's not a bad place to put it. You can carry it with you, you can charge it if you wish, or you can just wear it as jewelry. And it has, unlike the other two where we had chains, for this one, we have a very sturdy black rope instead, holding the pendant. You can always use it as a pendulum if you wish. However, like the other two, we do have the very popular lobster claw clasp. So once again, you would just push down this little piece to open the clasp, and you would put it through this little loop here. You can't adjust it to different lengths, like you could with the others too that I showed you already. However, if you just wanted to keep it simple, you wanted to keep an important crystal or your heart with you, it's not a bad option. Okay. Now, kind of still going along the theme of natural stones or natural products, I'd like to show you which is actually very special. So this is a very fancy pendant necklace. It has this very interesting metalwork detailing. We have these different shapes, spirals and curls all around it. In the center, we have a piece of lava stone from an island off the coast of Portugal. So this is a real lava stone. Lava stone is very absorbent, so you can actually see how it's very porous. It has all these little indents, little craters. You can actually stick essential oils on it if you wish. Give it a scent, or you can just wear it as is. But it's a very natural, beautiful piece, very one of a kind piece. The back is just shows you how it's all now put together. But the front is rather beautiful. It's very large, so if you're not into large necklaces, it may not be for you. The chain is very different. It's a very thick chain. Very, very thick. It's not heavy though. The pendant is large, but it's not heavy at all. It's actually pretty light. But the chain is very thick. So if you don't really like that look, that thicker chained look, you'd rather have something thinner. You can always switch out the chain, so the chain really shouldn't be a deterrent if you do like the pendant. Always change the chain if you wish, because the pendant's loop is rather large, so you can really find any chain and it should be able to hold it because it's not that heavy. But you can always keep the thick chain if you wish. This one also has a lobster claw. It's a very big lobster claw actually, and we have those big loops again. This one is a okay, that's another option if you're into the pendants and you're into natural stones.
Okay.
Now, this one is interesting. Unlike the other ones that I've shown you, it's not silver. This is more like a fake bronze color to make it look more antique. It is not an antique, but it just has that look to it. Now, this is a very mystical looking piece. It's actually a watch. On the back, it's super intricate. It has kind of lacy looking designs, swiggles, very beautiful. It has these little etchings up here that continue up the sides, and you have the watch part. This is a button actually that will open the watch. But first I will show you the front of the watch. This is what the display piece looks like. It has this beautiful star. Has the beautiful etchings around it. It has a crescent moon with some faux jewels that shine different colors, greens, blues, purples, pinks, and a little bit of white on the side. So you're gonna have these white ones on the side and in between. Ones. 1, 2, 3 of them. In the very middle, you have what looks like a moon. Also, shines different colors. Then you have the star. So if you turn it this way, and like crescent moon, almost like a full moon, and then a star. It's very beautiful. And this at the top right here is actually a button. So you press down and it opens. So you close it. Press down and it pops open. And inside you can see intricate detailing, metalwork. The clock no longer works. The battery just died on this one, so we'll replace the battery before we actually sell it to you. Okay. So this is the clock face. We have Arabic numerals, not Roman numerals around the face of the clock, so it's easier to read. And it does have these little dashes, these little rectangular, almost table-looking pieces, so you can more accurately tell the time. Now, the chain reflects that same kind of bronzed, antique-looking color, almost golden, almost like a rusted gold. It is one of the bigger looped chains. The chain itself is rather long. It's rather long. This pendant's a little bit heavier than the lava stone pendant. However, it's still not burdensome by any means. For this one, it is adjustable, so you do have this extra length of chain if you wanted to make it longer or shorter. Again, we have our lobster clasp closure. So it can be a rather long necklace, even when you adjust it, but if you don't mind long necklaces and you really enjoy the look of this antique piece, I think you'll really enjoy this one. Okay. Yes, it is good for Halloween if you wanted to go and look very mystical, maybe like a witch or something like that. It does look like a pendant. However, you can wear this every day as well, I think. Depending on your outfit, and especially since it has the batteries in, it is very functional. It's just more of a statement piece. I don't see any issue with wearing this every day, if you were interested in that. Okay. Alright, so that's the watch. Okay. We have a couple of movie-themed necklaces that you may enjoy, especially if you like Halloween. Now, this necklace is pretty special. So this diagonal fissure that you see here is actually a magnet. So these two pieces of the circle separate. They separate. And then you have, see the magnets? Magnetic pieces here and here. Magnetic pieces. And then they click together. This is actually considered a friendship necklace. So you could give half to your best friend, to your lover, and someone special. Maybe if you have children, you can give it to one of your children. And when you see each other, you can connect. You can click. Of course, you can also wear it alone. You don't need to have a buddy or separate the necklace by any means if you do not wish to. It's entirely up to you. But this theme, excuse the glare, this theme is the Nightmare Before Christmas. So Tim Burton created a claymation movie called The Nightmare Before Christmas. And this is the hill that was featured in that movie. And this is a cute little love story with Jack Skellington and Sally, who's a doll. And the skeleton and the doll fall in love. Hence, they were separated and now they're united. It doesn't close 100%, so you do see little pieces here and there. But when you're far away, you can't really tell. I don't think anyone's gonna be super up close to you. Just to see the necklace, they might be there. But yeah, it's a good movie. On the back, it's just plain, has the name of the company. Is there a different chain? So you have two chains here, one and two, and one and two. So you have four chains total because these necklaces, like I said, can be separated. So these two can be pulled apart. And you can have them as separate necklaces for whoever you wish to have separate necklaces for. Or you can just wear half if you wish. You just have half. Or you can give it someone special. Entirely up to you. Once again, we have this silver chain with the loops. It does get tangled a bit if you together. There are two lobster claws. One is hidden inside here. We will give you a better necklace if you purchase one today. It's just a display piece, so it's been there for a while. People have played with it, so it got a little tangled. But it does have two clasps because obviously it can separate the necklaces, and each has its own clasp, and then you would clip them together if you wanted to, and you can. They both are adjustable, so each necklace is adjustable. And you can also adjust it accordingly, as you wish, if you wear the whole piece together. Okay. I had worn this once when I was working with children, and they loved the magnets. So if you have children, or you work with children, or you have any nieces and nephews, or anything like that, and you're around the little ones, they just may want to play with it a lot. If you're like me, you may want to play with it anyway. No shame in that whatsoever. And it's really clever how they did this, because the whole piece, the gold pendant is the moon. It's a full moon. And it's in the background of Jack and Sally on the hill. You can see the full moon in the background. And that's what the circle is. So it's actually a really clever, fun friendship necklace. But like I said, you can always wear it yourself if you wish. You can wear one half, or you can wear both at the same time. You can really switch it up. Continuing along with the theme of movies, we do have another movie piece. This one does have some earrings that are themed from the movie too, but we're gonna stick with the necklaces for now, and we can get to the earrings in a bit, okay? Now this is a faux gold, fake gold. This is the time turner. The time turner from the movie Harry Potter. Prisoner of Azkaban. It's the third Harry Potter in the series. Harry Potter is originally a book, but it was made into 8 films. Very popular films. And if you like Harry Potter, you'll recognize this. Now, in the movie, you could turn these and this would turn. I wish it did that, but it doesn't. These are staple on the side. And you have this big circle and then another circle. Circles that make up this necklace, and this necklace moves quite a bit, so it's fun to play with if you have nothing else to do. So the whole idea is that this is a time turner. When you spin this middle piece a certain number of times, you go back in time. No, I don't think it works. This one, because you don't have the fancy spinning on the side, it doesn't work. If you did, maybe you could go back. So this middle piece turns. This other piece goes up and down because it has writing on it. If you can see, so this middle part and the top. So this top part has some letters, has some words on it. As does this middle piece here. You have different words on this. Let me say, I mark the hours, every one. Or have yet outrun the sun. And then the middle piece says, I have to find the beginning. My use and value unto you are gauged by what you have to do. That's what they say. That's what the outer ring says and what the inner ring says. Now, it does have sand in this hourglass in the middle. Good if you're going somewhere boring and you need something to play with. No, they're telling you you can't have your phone or something. Guess what? You have a necklace. It's also good for Halloween. If you were, say, going as Hermione Granger, who's the character that had this pendant and who used it in the third movie. Of course, you can also wear it every day if you wish. Your wardrobe and accessory choices are completely. So you have these fun rings, you can spin, or you can flip. You can also flip the other way too, if you wish. Go the other way. And you also have the sand to play with, so there's a lot of moving parts. And then you have these stars. You have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 on this side. Sand, I find, is the most mesmerizing part. You can really have fun with the sand. But yeah, the The pendant itself is light. It's a little heavy, but very, very minimal. It's really not bad. This is actually a very short necklace. This one's very short. We have the looped chain again. This is a different clasp. So the other ones we saw were lobster claw clasps. This is a toggle clasp. A toggle clasp has this straight piece and then a circle. So what the idea of it is that if you stick the piece, this piece, inside that, and it opens. If you want to close the necklace so it fits you, you stick the stick part. You stick the stick in the hole. So you go like this. And then you push it in so that this stick is horizontal or vertically against this instead of straight in and out. If it's in and out, you can get it out. This holds the necklace in place. So it should be sturdy. So this is definitely a fun option, especially if you're bored. So really, this necklace and the friendship necklace are really good boredom. Different from all the others, quite a bit, but it's a very classic look. It's a very beautiful look. This is a choker necklace. A choker necklace is something that goes against your neck, like a collar, essentially. So it looks like a collar. It should not actually choke you. It's just tighter around the neck, so that it stays up. It's not dangling really down, it's up against your neck. So it is a tighter fit than the other ones that we saw. Now this one's very beautiful. It has lace detail here. The whole thing is lace. And then you have these chains, that's black painted chains that hang down. It does have a tendency to tangle a little bit. You might want to keep it separate from your other necklaces, or keep it in a very straight way. And then we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 beautiful black stars in between each of the chains on the back. Again, a lobster claw, lobster clasp. You do sell some with the chain, so you can extend it or shorten it as you wish. But for the most part, this is roughly a one size fits all. So you would just undo the clasp like you would with anything else. And it would hold up right against your neck. And it actually looks very beautiful. It is, yes, it's good for Halloween, but it's good for every day too, honestly. It's a very statement piece. It's very beautiful. Anyway, I really like the Gothic look. And this is definitely a Gothic look. So if you're into that style, you just want to try it out, this is a nice way to do it. Some of them just have the lace, or they just have a chain or something like that, and they don't have these dangly pieces. Against the skin. It looks really beautiful. Those are most of our necklaces. Did any of those really stick out to you at all? Did you like more that the earthy ones, the one with the crystals, with Native American kind of imagery on it? Do you like the more mystical Gothic look? Do you like the movie ones? Did any of those appeal to you at all? Okay. We can look at other things. Are you interested in any bracelets? Okay, well, I have a couple to show you. So the first comes as a set. Now, since you seem to really enjoy Halloween, these might appeal to you. They're just plastic, hard plastic, almost gelatin-like They're not very stretchy, but they will fit. You just have to squish them over your hand to make them fit. But we have an orange one that has some yellow glittery pieces in it. And we have a black one with the same glittery pieces in it. And together they make the classic orange and black Halloween colors. Of course, you can always wear them separately or have them on two different wrists. You can put them together. You can intertwine them a little bit if you wish. Almost braid them. Maybe if you're going to work and maybe you have a Halloween party, or it's just Halloween day and you have to work because it's not a federal holiday. You can wear these to be festive, especially if you're not allowed to wear costumes at work or school or wherever you are. This isn't a bad option to be in the holiday spirit. You can always wear these every day as well, depending on your outfit or what you're looking for. Maybe you just like the orange and black look, which there's nothing wrong with that. So these are options. These are definitely one of our cheaper options. So if you ever wanted to just pair these with anything else that you would get, some metal work or anything like that, you can certainly do so, okay? This is the orange and black bracelet set. Yes, you could purchase them separately if you wish, but honestly, they're cheap enough. You can just keep the pair if you're not opposed to that. You could also make this a friendship bracelet type thing where you have one friend with the black, one friend with the orange, and you come together and you make Halloween. The next bracelet that we have has a similar black rope to the necklace with the rose quartz crystal. It has double, so two ropes combined. They're just tied. There are two knots here, and this is how you adjust it. You can pull on these sides, these little side bits. You can pull on them to make the bracelet smaller if you have small wrists, or you just want a tighter fit, and you can bring these closer if you want this to be looser. It is adjustable. I know it is hard when you have bracelets. If you have especially little wrists, it can be really tough to find bracelets that don't fall all the way down your arm. You kind of rest here instead of up here, or they come up to your hand and they're stuck near your knuckles or something like that. So it is nice to have the adjustable option so that you can tighten it or loosen it as you need. Now this is a figure eight. A figure eight, or an infinity sign, means forever. So this is a really good piece if you wanted to give it to a loved one or to yourself to say, hey, I love you forever. Infinite faith. Figure eight, the word infinite faith. You have a knotted closure, adjustable closure. So it's a very simple piece, but it is very beautiful when you put it on the wrist. It's very beautiful. And you can stick the words however you wish. You can face it here, or you can flip this so that the other way. It's entirely option. It would be really beautiful to pair with the quartz pendant because they're both very simplistic and they both have that black rope design, so they match really, really well. Of course, you can always pick one over the other or neither if you want. It's entirely up to you. Now, I have one more bracelet I'd like to share. This one's very different. It is a silver sterling silver, so it's not fake, as in it won't make your wrist green or anything like that. None of our jewelry will do that to you. Even our rings will not turn anything green. Okay. It says in etched letters S-H-A-N-D-I. Shanti. 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 Shanti means so it really would pair very well with the infinity symbol too, if you want it on one wrist, the other, or pair them together on one wrist. It's up to you what you prefer. This closure is very interesting. It looks like it would be one of those things where it's just stuck like this, but it's not. You can actually pull this open and push this closed. So you can make it fit your wrist. Pushing and pulling it so you can stick it over your wrist and then you can squish it so that it runs as far up and down your arm as you wish. And then when you're done, you can always just, I always pull it against myself and then you can lift it off very easily. So it's a very simple bracelet to put on and off yourself. So if you were in a hurry or something like that and you wanted something very simple but classic, you can throw this on yourself. You don't need someone helping you with a lobster clasp or something like that. Very easy. Okay. So this is the Shanti bracelet, which is a good option. Now, did you like any of the bracelets in particular? Did any stand out to you? Or the type of closure that you prefer or the material you like? Bracelets aren't your thing. That's okay. That's her. How about earrings? Would you like to try earrings? Okay. Yeah. Well, since you seem to like the boredom Harry Potter necklace, what goes really well with that, if you wanted to, are these. Now, these are from the 7th and 8th Harry Potter movies. Or the 7th. These are the Deathly Hallows. So the Deathly Hallows, you have the stick, the wand, which is the Elder Wand. You have the triangle, which represents the invisibility cloak, the cloak that fools death. And the circle in the middle represents the resurrection stone that can bring back the dead. So, three tools. The most powerful wand in the world, the resurrection stone, and the invisibility cloak together make the Deathly Hallows that can fool death. Now, these earrings are tingly earrings. We tend to specialize in tingly earrings. We like them the best. These are shorter tingly earrings, but they're still really elegant. Simple, but elegant. Very beautiful. Show your Harry Potter fandom. And of course, we have the earring part, the part that goes in the hole in your ear. We have these little rubber pieces that come off and can be put back on. So that the earring doesn't fall out of your ear at all. You can shake them. Yes. Oh, that's a very legitimate concern. I have the same concern. All of our earrings, all of them, are hypoallergenic. All of them. All of our jewelry in general is hypoallergenic. So nothing will make you turn green. Nothing will harm your ears. They won't get harmed at all. Very gentle materials. We always use high quality, gentle materials so that everyone can wear these safely, and no one has to worry about reading the back of the package to see if they're hypoallergenic, because they automatically are. We only sell hypoallergenic jewelry. Okay? That's it for the themed jewelry that we have right now. However, I have two pairs of earrings that are very Halloween themed. As it seems you do enjoy Halloween, you might really enjoy these earrings. These are also very antique looking, very classic, very vintage. So if you like vintage looks, especially more 1800s, 1900s, you might enjoy these. Now these Cameos are essentially busts, portraits. So from approximately the chest up, or the shoulders up, you see a face, side profile of a face, in a circle. In this case, it's very Halloween-esque. We have this skeleton-looking woman, her hair here, and she has a beautiful black rose in her hair that sticks out. She herself, if you stick her under a light or stick her in the window to get daylight, she will glow in the dark. Around the edges, we have these beautiful black designs. Very antique, very old-fashioned looking, very beautiful. At the top, we have this beautiful little bow, black bow. We have the earring piece, and even though it's black, like I said, it's hypoallergenic. Of course, you have that little rubber piece to keep everything in place. Okay. So that's an option. These are very fun. So, I personally love wearing these on Halloween. These are skeletons. Just like the woman in the cameo. They glow in the dark, so the eyes do not glow in the dark, but the bodies of the skeletons do glow in the dark. They move because they have these chains in between the bones, the main bones, so that they move and make a really interesting sound. And they're very big. They're not heavy, but they're big. You'll feel them whacking you because they're very large, but they're not anatomically correct per se. They're close enough to look good and to know that they're skeletons. They have their teeth. They have these fake red jewels for eyes. They look good even on the back, so when they move and you see the back of them, it won't look odd because it's not fully flat. Still has the etching of the ribs, so it's one of those earrings where even if it flips around, it looks good. And they're just very different. They're very interesting, and they look really good, and they're perfect for Halloween. Of course, hypoallergenic, and the piece to hold it together. This is a smaller piece, just a rectangle, but it's enough to hold these guys. These are little skeletons. What did you think of those options? Yeah. Okay, that's alright. I love dangly earrings myself, but if you prefer studs or something like that, or just smaller, lighter pieces, yeah, it may not be for you, but that's alright. To each his own. So, if you're interested, you can move on to rings. We have different sizes, so we have sizes for each of your fingers. We have tons of sizes, and if we have to get it to our workshop to get it sized for you, we do that for free, okay? Once again, these do not make your finger green. Over here, we have another crescent moon with a soul jewel in the middle, as if it's either a star or a full moon. And you can wear this up. You can wear this down. However you face the points of the moon are entirely up to you. If you find after you purchase it that it does not fit the way you wished, especially when your hands get bigger or smaller depending on the weather and the temperature, and it's not comfortable for you, you can bring it back. Just bring a receipt, bring it back, and we'll size it for you, okay? So that's one option. Our next option, go for the jeweled ones. Now, once again, this is a fake jewel, but this is very beautiful, this piece. It has very intricate edgings around the edges, and then a plain band that goes around the fake jewel. It kind of looks like a little bit of a moon. It has a little bit of a shine to it, and it has just a basic silver band. Okay, it has a teardrop shape, so it's up to you if you want the teardrop to face down, or if you prefer it entirely up to you. You can always switch it. Maybe you're not in a good mood and you're like, nope, down. And then maybe you're in a good mood the next day and it comes up. Entirely up to you. Very simple piece, but it is very beautiful. Alright, our next jeweled piece is this one. It is larger on your finger than the other ones I showed you. It's pointy. It's a little pointy. Top and the bottom, and just like we saw before, the same type of jewel, that iridescent moon-esque jewel. We have two, and it's a mirror image. So no matter which way you put this, it looks the same. It has these intricate detailings around it. It's a little bit on the ring part that goes on your finger, but it doesn't hurt. So we have this option. We also have, okay, this is a flower. So it's a flower with a little stick out piece in the middle. It has some leaves. It's almost smudgy, if you know what I mean, right? The metalwork is very dark, so it kind of has a smeared look to it with these little almost jewel-esque metal pieces sticking out of it. Nature, that could be a good option. This is a mood ring. Now a mood ring bases what color the band is on the temperature. So if it's cold, it'll look usually black. So it's cold now, so it looks black. And if it's a warmer temperature, it usually looks blue or purple, green, has different colors, yellow. So the band itself will change different colors. But the twist is all these little sparkles that are inside the ring itself. So allegedly, each color is supposed to represent a different mood. Brown and black are supposed to be not so positive moods, and blues and greens and things are supposed to be better moods. There is a little card that comes with it that tells you what the moods are, but really, in reality, it's temperature based. So that's our mood ring. Alright. I know that was a lot, but did any of those appeal to you? The rings, the necklaces, anything. I know you said the earrings weren't your thing, but did anything appeal to you at all? Okay. So it seems like you like the edgier pieces, the more gothic-esque pieces. Do you mind if I show you two more things? They definitely are edgy. Okay. They're not necessarily jewelry pieces, but they're accessories. So the first one are these gloves. They are fingerless gloves. So you stick your hand inside and your fingers point out. This is your thumb. They have this cutout piece so you can see the skin of your hand through it. To put these on, You could just slip your hand in if you can fit, but in all likelihood, you're going to have to unclasp this. So you just pull it. It's just a button, so you just stick it. Just stick it back on. Or pull it apart. And you slip on the glove. We do have different sizes for different hands. But you would then take this part, this piece. Wear just one if you wish, or you can wear both at the same time. It's entirely up to you what you prefer. Very sturdy. It's a faux leather, it's not real, but it's definitely very edgy. There's the fingerless bits here. This is what it looks like. It's very comfortable actually, and it's pretty warm. So if you're like me and you work at the computer a lot, and your hands suffer from the cold, mostly around the knuckle area, this is actually not a bad option to wear if you're typing, if you're at work, or anything like that. Of course, you can wear this as a Halloween accessory. Maybe if you have a bike, you can ride your bike. Your motorcycle, whatever you have with it, to look edgy. But it's up to you. What looks great and also edgy are these next items. We have 10 of these. We have a whole set for all of your fingers, but these are very interesting. They come individually packaged so that they don't tangle. Have this pointy bit, this triangle. It is adjustable, so you just squish it or pull it as you need to. And it has these chains that link it to this ring piece. So this is a type of, almost like a ring, but it can fit on different parts of your fingers. And it also is adjustable, so you squish it, or you pull it apart. You can stick on any of your fingers and adjust accordingly. And then you kind of want to stick this on, squish it, push this down. You can always move it up or down if it's too much on the knuckle. But this is what it looks like. So you have the chain between. You have this little nail piece. Very intricate black metal design. You have this beautiful stick out rose. Side, very intricate. It's very interesting. So if you're like me and your nails are nubby, and you just want to know what it's like to have long nails, this is not a bad option. It does fall off a little bit. You definitely have to do the adjustments to get it to fit. But if you wanted to, you could have these on one hand and the gloves on the other. You could try to make them fit together. It's a little hard because these go kind of down the finger. Them for all 10 fingers, so you can either buy 5 maybe if you just wanted one hand, you can buy all 10 so you can mix it up, or so you have an extra pair if something happens to the first pair. So these are definitely options. They're very different. They're good for Halloween for sure, but if you just want to play with them or just, you know, be edgy for the heck of being edgy, you can definitely do it. You probably can't do much with these on. They're not very practical in that sense, but you wanted to play with them, most certainly could do that. They make phenomenal tappings of this. So if you're into that, it might be for the heck of it, since we do have a lot of boredom pieces. Look at that. He looks good. But those are definitely an option if you wish. So, did any of the different items appeal to you at all? Those different accessories. Yeah. The gloves are comfortable. Just saying. And these are just fun. Just for the heck of it. So, it's totally up to you. You do not have to decide today. We're open Monday through Friday. But we open late too. So if you work during the day, we have options then. And we are open every other Saturday. You can visit our website if you need to know when we're open. But please do come back anytime you wish when we're open to see and to maybe revisit any of the pieces. We get new pieces pretty frequently. We do tend to keep the staples, like our fancy, you can't find it easily anywhere pieces. We're definitely going to keep in stock for those who are interested in such things. We do try to broaden our horizons and find very interesting pieces that either are popular, such as the movie ones, the movie-themed ones, that are just interesting or intricate, maybe antique or gothic in nature, and definitely good for Halloween, because that is our specialty. Yeah, no, that's not a problem. I thank you so much. It was really lovely to meet you.